miserable start to the season. Andre Markov goes back, being watched by Tarasenko. Centers for Schwartz with a quick shot. Saved by Price, the rebound. And Berglund turned away by Carey Price as well. Now another chance for Tarasenko on the feed from Schwartz. And Carey Price comes up with a hat trick of good saves.
In the Habs net, Tarasenko and Schwartz have played together quite a bit on the season for the Blues. Hitchcock was telling us this morning that Schwartz reminds him a lot of the way Brendan Gallagher plays the game.
The Ocean tries to throw that ahead. Douglas Murray had that skip over his stick. And it's center ice Pacioretty tied up with Oshie. Now Douglas Murray gets bottled up by Backes, who knocks him down. Backes centers. Steen scores! Alexander Steen, his 13th of the year. And just like that, the Blues have a 1-0 lead.
Douglas Murray just skated back and patted Carey Price on the pads, acknowledging his bad on this play. I mean, there's really nothing going on here. Murray doesn't read the play at all, and when he gets back, he's got plenty of time, but he doesn't notice where Backes is coming from. He doesn't think, it appears as though Backes is going to come behind the net, and when he does, look at Murray, he loses the puck here. He wants to reverse it. Now he just kicks it right back onto the stick of Black, but Black hasn't broken a sweat here tonight.
Now Stewart drops it back, and Shattenkirk drives twice the save through traffic. Bollmeister tries to tap it back in front, and away come the Canadians, shorthanded 2-on-1. Pacioretty and Eller. Max Pacioretty flips it back in front, broke by Halak. Still loose at the side of the goal, and Pacioretty had that knocked away from him.
Here comes the Canadiens' fourth line, and here goes Reeves and Paris.
And St-Pierre got a late shot away. It's no goal because there's going to be scoring of a different kind. This is something that Reeves' dad, Willard, never had to do in the CFL. Winds up on top of the end.
England and Oshie, and you know, they made the deal for Stewart.
Subban, a long shot. Halak the save. Rebound loose in front. Eller can't get to it. And now Schwartz out ahead to Tarasenko. Swatted away by PK Subban, and then goes low on Tarasenko and takes him off the puck.
Oh, Halak, he beats Berglund on the draw, and a pretty quick release by Subban. Not the big slapper, and Halak has trouble with it. Look at Eller gets there quickly off the draw. Brandon Preston, Daniel Briere started to skate. Briere out with a concussion. It's clear to start amping up his work.
Now a steal by Pacioretty. And Max Pacioretty sends it back in front to Gallagher with a chance. And Yaroslav Halak makes the save on him.
Good tenacity by Pacioretty to stay on the loose puck.
This year, Ray, he's seventh among Montreal defensemen.
That is hard to believe that he wouldn't be on the ice at all.
In comes Stewart with a chance. Oh, what a glove save by Price. Chris Stewart busting in, and Carey Price is keeping Montreal in this game.
Excellent release by Stewart. He gets into the middle of the block there for them. But you're right. I mean, they just seem to have so much depth offensively. They can hurt you many ways.
In comes Markov with a chance. Lockdown, rebound, Bork scores! Winnie Bork ties the game at 1. And Halak still down on the ice.
He got run into on the net drive by Andre Markov. Markov sees a little bit of room as he gets down below the goal line. The Blues lose coverage. Look at their coverage here. They're in decent shape, and when the puck goes behind the net, they start to chase. Nobody accounts for Markov. He gets inside of Sobotka and then drives across the front of the net. Nice stop here on the initial save by Halak, but the rebound goes right to Rene Bork, and Bork's fifth of the year, just his second at 5-on-5.
And Galchenyuk throws it out to the St. Louis zone. Halak way out to play it. Here's Gallagher with a chance. Halak was just getting back to his net and was able to make the emergency save on that. Now Stewart to Steen. That shot was blocked. PK Subban is down after blocking it and clutching his left arm. racing now to the Montreal bench as the Blues come in. Alexander Steen walking in, plays it across. The return pass for Steen, shoots it, Price got away with that. Somehow Carey Price kept that up. Now a backhand shot blocked in front. Price has no stick. Petrangelo couldn't keep it alive, and back from the Montreal Canadiens is Mikhail Bournival across the line. Shoots it, Halak fights that off. Bournival back on it. Drops back to George's kind of half hit that puck down. Giotto, round the wrong try, throws it in front. Petrangelo took that away from Bournival. Pacioretty backhands it in. And Halak has to wait for it as Leopold goes back with Bork on him. And Leopold got sandwiched between Eller and Bork. Tipped wide by Cracknell. Now Leopold with a
good finish.
Slam there by Bouillon. They're jousting in behind the play. Meantime, back to the American Thanksgiving. Now a steal by Bournival. In shoot scores! Mikhail Bournival! And Montreal has the lead!
Against Colorado on the weekend, Bournival had his first game as a Canadian this year without a shot on goal. Like most of the Canadians, had a quiet first period. He's had a couple here in the second. A turnover by Bouwmeester. Too slow to go D to D to Petrangelo. Giunta gets his stick on the puck to deflect it right here. And Bournival walks into it and gets a free rein to pound this through the wickets.
Chris Stewart tied up by Georges. And Louis LeBlanc brings it ahead with Eller and Bourque. Ellerin across the line, snaps that shot on goal, and Halak makes the stop. Of a trend for the Canadiens. You don't want to break up what could be tonight a winning lineup. Now Bournival sends it back in front. Great chance there for Giunta. And Halak makes a point-blank save. In the meantime,
I know a lot of forwards would be in favor of that.
Tarasenko centers it, and Subban knocked that away. In comes Bork with it, shoots, and Halak makes the save. A late tap there from Ryan White, and Halak didn't appreciate that.
Just together.
Now Petrangelo comes in as both teams are changing, drops it back for the trainer. That curve on the top, twice the save, rebound, and Stewart couldn't reach it. Now set back in front, Sobotka battling for it, and Carey Price once again shuts the door for Montreal.
What an excellent sequence here from Carey Price's. Petrangelo finds Shattenkirk coming off the bench. This goes through the screen. Price makes the first stop. And the second rebound goes right to Chris Stewart. Bouillon turns to try and deflect it, but it's Carey Price's
point of the shots on goal in favor of St. Louis. Pacioretty got hit in the face with that clearing attempt. And now Petrangelo centers. Oh, what a chance in front for Roy. Stopped by Bryant. Sobotka, the shot. Sobotka plays it back. Shattenkirk, a long drive, scores! Appeared to hit Chris Stewart in front, and this game is tied at two.
Canadians try to get a fourth line shift out on the ice as Parros and White, along with Pacioretty, go on the ice. And St. Louis ends up scoring the equalizer. Chris Stewart's been around the net most of the night. He's one of the players that Ken Hitchcock wants to be more involved in the play. This shot deflects a couple of times. It hits Pacioretty, it hits Stewart. There's no chance for Carey Price as you see it deflect off of Stewart at the tail end of the play. Kevin Shattenkirk's
eight-man scrum fails to resolve that. Now the Blues have a chance shorthanded. Sobotka walks in and fires. He missed far side. He had Jackman with him, an unusual combination for the Blues. Now back comes Montreal. Rennie Bork tried the move, drops it back. Eller for St-Pierre. Eller shoots, and Halak shuts him down. That shot broke Eller's stick. Back to Buchanan's with a shot. Halak the save. And the rebound knocked away by Backes, who went flying into the net. And I think that's going to be a delay of game penalty to the St. Louis Blues. Backes banged into Halak and then the net. And this is going to be a penalty call against the Blues.
And it is a penalty shot because it's a delay of game in the last 2 minutes of the game.
Well, the game on the line, the penalty shot called against the Blues. And Thomas Plekanec with a chance. In on Yaroslav Halak. Plekanec stopped by Halak.
Watch how aggressively Yaroslav Halak comes out of the net. Feet front of the crease. He checks his bearings to make sure he's set. And Plekanec wants to go blocker side as he drags it to his glove side. This hits the arm of...
In across the line now. Gets around Markov. David Backus back with it. Spins all the way through the zone. Back to Polak. Well, with Polak's long shot. Backhand shot by Steen. Stopped by Price. Now Giontek has it up for Montreal.
That's the tricky TJ Oshie.
Two for two so far this year. Oshie scores!
Price is right in front of the puck till the finish of Oshie. Oshie's got great hands, head up the whole way. He gets over to the forehand on Price, and you see Price is in good position, but this is a gritty chance.
In comes Pacioretty on Yaroslav Halak. Pacioretty fires it wide, and the St. Louis Blues win it by a score of 3-2 in the shootout.